whether it's acute or chronic. So you have your acute injuries and then your chronic or overuse injuries. The most common acute injuries are usually your lateral ankle sprains and then also your hamstring tears or adductor tears. Or sometimes you also have your rotator cuff problems or your rotator cuff tears. For chronic injuries, it's more of the overuse type. And the most common ones would be shoulder problems related to the overhead component of the sport, and also patellar tendinopathy because of the landing component involved in volleyball. And also you have some injuries that are actually related to it, to the hip.
Sometimes if you do an x-ray and you don't see a fracture but there's obviously pain, swelling, then it's probably a lateral collateral ligament injury, and MRI is still the best modality to evaluate the ligaments of the of almost any part of the limbs of the musculoskeletal system if you want to know what's the problem.
So with ankle sprain, it has been always discussed as to the most common thing that they ask would be, do I actually need to do imaging on this ankle first? That's the most common thing. And then, there's also already a study, the Ottawa Ankle Study, which is widely accepted, even at the level of the International Olympic Committee. And then, it just simply tells that, does this patient actually require an x-ray or not? So, it actually is very quite sensitive and specific. So, if the patient simply doesn't fall into the prerequisites of the Ottawa Ankle Study, they say that you don't need to have an x-ray for that ankle.
So in the arm and the hand, common injuries like dissociation of the scapulohumeral ligament, meaning the scaphoid and the lunate are pulled away from each other. There is gamekeeper's thumb. The ulnar collateral ligament of the thumb is damaged. So, with regards to immediate assessment, the first step is almost always an x-ray because x-rays can easily detect the obvious fractures and swelling. And maybe if there's dislocation of a bone. But if you really need further work, you can do CT scan and MRI. So CT scan is the best for fractures because you can see the fragments. But it's not the best for ligaments and tendons because that's MRI. MRI can also detect fractures, but it's more expensive. But it can definitely tell you what ligament is damaged, if there's edema of the underlying bone. Overall, MRI is really the best to detect injuries. It's expensive, yes.